that time, Mr. Steve will have to spend the choir screen to try and fix the problem. But welcome. Welcome everybody here. Can I thank you for all the cards? And they look amazing. And I've got two more here, so I'm just going to open these one here. Very clean on the floor. Oh, there we are. Thank you very much. Oh, I'm running out of space. Dorothy, I apologise for my really flat. One and all. I would say one more time to sing happy birthday, but you probably won't risk that now. Oh, wonderful. Thank you very much, everybody. And I welcome you all to our Patronal Festival. I think it reminds us that we are all together, we are the body of Christ. And that here in our Hallows, we remember all saints. We are all saints. Each one of us is uniquely and beautifully called to be one of God's saints in our own strange ways. I will remember that one of my favourite verses from Genesis. Let us make them in our own image. So male and female, he created them. Each of us as saints are made in his image. So we start with the gathering. No Christian is alone. Through baptism we become members one another in Christ, members of the company of saints, whose belonging transcends even death. In Christ, all are made one. Through him, all are hallowed. All are welcomed into God's kingdom. I welcome you.
We welcome you.
Grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
Let us rejoice together. Rejoice, people of God.
Praise the Lord.
Let us keep the feast of God's people.
Praise the Lord.
In whose victory the angels rejoice.
Praise the Lord.
Let us glorify the Son of God.
Praise the Lord.
So we come to that time when we remember the occasions when we have fallen short, when we have not done everything that we should have done, when we have said and done things we should not have done. Since we are surrounded by a great cloud of witnesses, let us also lay aside every weight and sin that clings so closely, looking to Jesus in penitence and faith. Lord, you are gracious and compassionate. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are loving to all, and your mercy is over all your creation. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Your faithful servants bless your name and speak of the glory of your kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sin. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness. And keep you in life eternal through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Let us pray. We may be strengthened by our communion with all who believe. God of all holiness, your glory is proclaimed in every age. As we rejoice in the faith of your saints, inspire us to follow their example with boldness and joy. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
And Dorothy will bring us our worship.
Reading from the first letter of John. See what love the Father has given us, that we should be called children of God, and that is what we are. The reason world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we will be has not yet been revealed. What we do know is this: when he is revealed, we will be like him, for we will see him as he is. And all who have this hope in him purify themselves, just as he is pure. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. When Jesus saw crowds, he went up the mountain, and after he sat down, his disciples came to him. Then he began to speak and taught them, saying, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you, and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven, for in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
May we who are saints share together in your word, celebrate your presence, give praise to your kingdom. Amen.
Amen.
A very odd year for birthdays. I had my birthday in August lockdown. We booked a holiday for Annie's birthday to realise we're now having her birthday in lockdown. It's a very strange time to share together. And yet the reality is, happy birthday. John, in an amazing letter to 1st Church of John, makes that wonderful statement that each of us should hold on to at these times. How great is the love of the Father. He has lavished on us that we should be called children of God, for that is what we are. We should be called children of God. That's not the best gift we can receive, I don't know what it is. It's a voucher that is eternal. John says again, "Dear friends, now we are children of God. What we will be has not yet been made known, but we know that when he appears, Jesus, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is." We should be like Jesus, fully restored in the image. At times like this, I think it's important and vital and glorious to know this. It's vital information that we will be like Jesus. It's vital, it makes us alive. Vital as it gives us life. It's vital because it is life. This is the gift that we have received, that we are children of God, and that when Christ returns, we will be restored to the full image of God. We shall appear as he is. And knowing that, we can turn and look at the Beatitudes, that wonderful teaching that Christ gave. We look at that wonderful passage through the promise that we have received and will receive. The Beatitudes in Matthew's Gospel, as many of you will know, begins a passage that's often called the Sermon on the Mount. It's three chapters of Jesus' teaching through which he examines what it is to believe and follow God, in which he questions the perceptions of the time and then gives answers to who he is. The teaching on the Sermon on the Mount that Matthew gives is more than just a praising of what Jesus teaches. It gives us two questions to consider. Who is this man? And what does it mean if I follow him? By the time you get to the end of the Sermon on the Mount, those answers, those questions are for you to think about. They are not comfortable, but they can be life-changing. The Jesus on the Sermon on the Mount preaches with authority. It is different from a rabbinical tradition in which things are quoted. He says, you have heard it said that I said. He owns what he is saying. He doesn't press it by saying somebody else has said this, or somebody else has said that, or in the tradition of. He says, I say. The other thing Matthew's Gospel is very clear about is even though there were crowds there, as Jesus begins to teach the Beatitudes, he talks to his disciples. He looks at them and begins to preach. The disciples came to him and he began to teach them. So even though there were crowds present, the people that the Sermon on the Mount is addressed to are those who are following him. Is addressed to us. And he starts with the Beatitudes. He looks at that thing about the character of what it means to follow Jesus and the reality of what it means to follow Jesus. The bit at the end where he talks about the persecution. It's a thing that Christ has come back to time and time again. If they have persecuted me, they will persecute you. If they have not believed me, they will not believe you. And he wants his disciples to understand, as he talks to them, that is the reality. And yet he also gives us something else. If you look at the beginning of the Beatitudes, the first one and the last one make a fascinating statement. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And the last one, number 8, blessed are those who are persecuted because of righteousness, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. The other 6 that sit in the middle finish with they will. First one and the last one tell us what is already ours. This is one of the fascinations of us following Christ. That as children of God, we are already part of the kingdom of heaven. Jesus is, throughout Matthew's Gospel, talking about the kingdom of heaven. He uses the terms 30 plus times. And he wants his disciples and his followers to understand that the kingdom of heaven is here because he is here. And that as we follow him, we are already in the kingdom. That's what it means to be saints. You're already in the kingdom. Today, as we celebrate All Saints Day, we join in the praises of heaven. We're already in the kingdom. But the six in the middle remind us that that doesn't mean we are already passed through persecution, that we've already passed through the troubles. We have the kingdom, but on Christ's return, we will get more. Jesus begins his mission by saying, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is near." As he goes on, he time and time again says, "The kingdom of heaven is here. The kingdom is now." But also in a strange way, not now. We are already in the kingdom, but we will become like Christ fully on his return, as John says in his letters. In the Beatitudes, we are reminded that we are blessed. Blessed through these present times, in this present situation. Blessed in what is going on around us. That we have a future hope and a future promise. But that is because we are already in the kingdom. How great is the love of the Father that we should be called children of God, for that is what we are. In the strangeness of these times, we need to remember that we are already in the kingdom. In the stresses and strains of these times, we are in the kingdom. We are already sharing in the glory. It doesn't remove us from this present situation. It doesn't take us away. We live through it with everyone else. We pray through it with everyone else. As we enter lockdown again, we are aware of the struggles we may have. We're also aware that the guarantee has been given, the gift voucher has been there. But why? Because of who Jesus is. In these strange times, we know it is wearing and distressful. We know that we can feel alone, unsure. And yet, the Father loves us. And we know when he appears, we shall be like him. For we shall see him as he is. There is our hope. We saints together. We share in kingdom. We are part of the struggle. But God's love is lavish upon us. God's love is giving us the promise that will be fulfilled. We are one together in the praises of our Father. Maybe we should return now and read the Sermon on the Mount. Study it. And see, as we come to the end, the reality of what it is to be in the kingdom, working for the kingdom, and still waiting to receive the full glory of the kingdom. Father God, we are your saints. We are your saints in glory because your love has been lavished upon us. We are your saints in glory because Christ is with us. We are your our saints in glory, because you bless us through all that we struggle through. Father, bless us in your kingdom. And when your Son returns, restore us to the full image of your glory that he so wonderfully shines with. Amen. Shall we make our profession of faith? Let us declare our faith in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist?
We believe and trust in him.
Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again?
We believe and trust in him.
Believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world.
We believe and trust in him.
This is the faith of our church.
This is our faith.
We believe and trust in one God,
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Would you like to be seated for our prayers? Our prayers this morning have been written by Jean. Thank you, Jean. Holy Father God, we adore you in your immense glory, which we witness day by day, as we awake to each new dawn, as we walk on the green earth and gaze into the endless sky by day and the stars by night. We worship you, Lord, and thank you for the mysteries of which we are a part in our time and in your time, threading through the life of Jesus Christ, your Son. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father, we approach you on this Feast of All Saints. We thank you for the Church and for the opportunity to remember the people who have gone before us, sealed with the faith of your love, given to speak, sing, and enact your beautiful love to others, that all may know the intricacy of praise and thanksgiving. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Father God, remember that we too are but a part of the story of the saints, and we ask for your help now, humbly, during this pandemic, in our separation, in our anxiety, without being able to sing. Father, heal us. Father, please enable us afresh. Father, show us the way to life. Amen. Lord Jesus, friend, hold us as we reach out to our neighbours in their distress. Bless the communities in which we live and bring Nottingham safely through the COVID lockdown. We pray for our local leaders and especially for David Mellon, that they get Tier 3 funding for local businesses, particularly for the sole traders and small enterprises from central government. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Dear Jesus, our friend, please bless the Church's enterprise so that she can trade in the gift of your love to all who seek your mercy, to all who need the guidance of prayer, to those hungry for baptism and marriage. Show to all generous hearts how their financial support of the Church will inspire a new generation of praise to grow. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, we pray for the sick and the dying, and especially those affected by COVID, those isolated at home without adequate food supplies, those on ventilators in hospital, those who are afraid due to the delay in their critical cancer operations. Lord, bring your healing touch. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our
prayer. Lord Jesus, on this All Saints Day, we praise and thank you for the faith of our forebears who have witnessed your amazing love, your astonishing intelligence, and your beautiful gifts. Merciful Father,
Accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
So we come to that time in our service when we can share the wonders of God's peace. Remember, there is an example of God lavishing his love on us. It's the fact that we can share in his peace. We are fellow citizens with the saints and of the household of God through Jesus Christ our Lord, who came and preached peace to those who were far off and those who were near. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Shall we offer one another a wave of peace? Peace be with you. Peace be with you at home. Upon us in mercy and not in judgment. Draw us from heaven to the dark. Make the frailty of our praise a dwelling place for your glory. Praise the Lord. Amen. The Lord is here.
His Spirit is with us.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is always right to give you thanks. God, our Creator, loving and faithful, holy and strong, you made us in the whole universe and filled your world with life. Holy, holy, holy. You sent your Son to live among us, Jesus our Saviour, Mary's child. He suffered on the cross. He died us to save us from our sins. He rose in glory from the dead. Holy, holy, holy. You send your Spirit to bring new life to the world and clothe us with power from on high. And so we join with the angels to celebrate and sing. Holy, 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 holy God. God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. Father, on the night before he died, Jesus shared a meal with his friends. He took bread and thanked you. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." After the meal, Jesus took the cup of wine. He thanked you and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, the new promise of God's unfailing love. Do this in remembrance of me." Christ has died.
Christ has died.
Christ is risen.
Christ is risen.
Christ will come again.
Christ will come again.
Father, we bring this bread and this wine and remember his death and resurrection. Send your Holy Spirit that we who share in these gifts may be fed by Christ's body and his blood. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Pour your Spirit on us, that we may love one another, work for the healing of the earth, and share the good news of Jesus as we wait for his coming in glory. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. For all honour and praise belong to you, Father, with Jesus Christ, your Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. With all the saints and martyrs through the ages, as our Saviour taught us, let us pray together. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. I heard the voice of a great multitude crying, Hallelujah! The Lord our God has entered into his kingdom. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Hallelujah! As with all weeks, I can ask you to come up the side aisle, so it's sanitized there. I will be here to receive. I will not be using any words. Give. If you wish to receive a blessing, I will give a blessing in the form of Christ. Again, in silence. Come, let us share together that which God has given us.
body of Christ, broken for us. The blood of Christ, shed for us. God, the source of holiness and giver of all good things, may we who have shared this table as strangers and pilgrims here on earth be welcomed with all your saints to the heavenly feast on the day of your kingdom. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. We thank you, Lord, that you have led us in this sacrament, united us with Christ, and given us the full taste of the heavenly man. Things have moved to pace. We have been asked to close churches for the month of November in line with the new lockdown. So that will mean there will be no services in here until possibly the first Sunday in December. What we will do is obviously I'm aware that next Sunday is Remembrance Sunday. As a minister, I am committed to perform services in church with nobody else present. So I will actually be doing the service of remembrance as a live stream through Facebook. So if you wish to come and join me, you're more than welcome to. Even at times like this, I think it is important that we remember those who gave so much for freedom for our country. So I will be doing that on Sunday. You can join me if you like, live through Facebook Live, or later on it will be on YouTube as well if you should come to it later and watch it later. What that also means is any of the church meetings like PCCs will, if it is set for November, need to be conducted online through Zoom. The other thing I would say is that I'm very aware that normally we would have a service of commemoration on All Saints Day for those who wish to remember those who have lost their loved ones, etc. Again, it's not been possible, but what we have done is if you wish to bring and tie a ribbon to the front of the church gates in remembrance of the people you've lost. When it comes to Advent Sunday, I will pray and bless those ribbons. I think again it's important that though we may not be able to get together in the way that we normally would to remember those that we have lost and those that we have loved, that we do something to actually say we want to acknowledge those people. So please feel free to come to simply tie a ribbon onto the gate for the person you want to think about, and they will be, those ribbons will be in my prayers, and I know in the prayers of many people in this building. Again, it's about recognising we may not be able to do things the normal way, but we can do something that expresses our love for the people we love. So, I think what else, Paul? Obviously, this is our birthday. Thank you again for all the wonderful cards. I will scan them all in and put some YouTube clips together so that everybody can see who's all these wonderful cards, all these wonderful pictures. Thank you, those folk who are here today. We have 7 cards. It is wonderful. Can I also remind you that as is our tradition, there are the birthday present envelopes on the chairs if you wish to give towards the work of the church and continue to maintain what we are doing here. I can't think of anything else, but I'm looking towards the wall.
Are you doing a service on Wednesday before the lockdown starts?
There will be a service here on Wednesday for communion. I promise that we will begin them in November, so we'll begin them and finish them. But it will be the last. It will be the last service we have before lockdown. So that will be as normal on a Wednesday, but 9 o'clock here. It will be set communion. If you wish to come and join us, it would be more wonderful to see. It will be done in this space because obviously where we normally do it, we can't. So we will do it here. All I can say is these are complicated times. But if we hold each other in our prayers, if we phone to each other, pray for each other, if there's anything you need from me, you have my number and my email, please get in touch. If there's somebody you're concerned about and you feel you'd like me to contact them, or Jean to contact them, or one of the pastoral team, again, please email us, phone us. I am not telepathic. I have discovered that after many years of living with Annie, I still don't know what she's thinking about the dog. And if I've lived with her for as long as I have, I can't get it. I certainly can't. So please, include us in. Send us an email. I'd rather have 20 emails about one person people are worried about than no emails and then discover that somebody's been said, I thought you should call them. But please, be in touch. Keep in touch with each other. We are all saints. We have already got the gift. We are in the kingdom. And we will move through this because of the Beatitudes. We will remember that what we will receive again. So I'm going to finish with the All Saints blessing for all you wonderful saints, both those in this church and those out there and those beyond the doors. God, who has prepared for us a city with eternal foundations, give you grace to share in the inheritance of the saints in glory, and the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be amongst us and remain with us always. Amen. Shall we say the acclamation as our farewell to each other and as our hope in eternity? Great is the Lord. Hallelujah. Greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. We shall praise your works. Hallelujah. We shall declare your power. Hallelujah. We praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. We shall bless you, Lord. Hallelujah. Let all things, living and breathing, alive and eternal, saints in glory, bless his holy name, forever and ever. Hallelujah. Go in peace to love and serve our Lord.
In the name of Christ.